Welcome to our first Indoor Rev tutorial. Behind me you can see the actual Indoor Revs, as well as a B2, or in that Rev 2 class size, that's actually been custom fitted for indoor flying. We will do some later tutorials on the B2 class of kite, because it's a lot smaller and trickier, and some of the techniques that you'll use to fly are a little bit different. But in the first series, what we're going to do is cover the Indoor Rev specifically. It's made especially for indoor flying, and the one thing that makes it very advantageous is the huge amount of sail area that it has compared to the very low amount of frame weight that it has. So it's very light, and because of its large sail area, it creates a great deal of pressure, and that's what allows it to fly. So I'm going to work under the assumption that those of you who are watching this video may have never actually seen or been introduced to the dynamics of indoor flying before. So what I want to explain first is how does a kite fly indoors? Because of course there's no wind. Well, the simple way to look at that is that wind outside, as we experience it, is air, just like I have here, except that it's in motion from the elements and pressure and temperature. Indoor, the same air exists, except that it's not in motion. So if the wind is typically moving like this, then we will move indoor to create that same amount of wind. And you might be surprised to know that it doesn't take more than 1 to 3 mph of walking speed to actually allow a kite to fly indoors. And then that, of course, is accentuated by that range, that additional pull that we can give to accentuate the pressure. And you'll see that come into play as we go through the different tutorials. But the indoor rev, basically the way that it works, again, as I described, and I'm gonna give you the side view of this kite so you can actually see it. The kite, basically, when you pull on it, it pressurizes. And you can see that the sail, particularly here in the center, near the V, bow outward as it cups and grabs that wind, just like that, okay? So basically, once that kite is pressurized, that pressure has to go somewhere. So when we pull our top line slightly more towards us, like this, that pressure goes out the bottom and allows the kite to fly forward. If we pull on the bottom tips a little bit more and pressurize it, that drives the wind up off the leading edge and allows the kite to fly backwards. And then if you're just using one turn control, that will of course allow the kite to spin and rotate. So you know, that's your basic principle. When you become very adept at indoor flying, you can actually be stationary in a chair or on your knees or whatever and fly in place just by keeping the kite in the right range of motion around you, so that you're always able to pull away with your hands, driving the kite into a new position where you're able to again drive away. So even stationary, once you have enough practice time in, you can actually fly without a lot of movement. So it becomes very casual. It's sort of a mysterious concept when you first start learning, but with some of the dynamics that we'll describe in the tutorials, I think that you'll find it'll come to you pretty readily. Now, the other thing that I want to show you here are the types of handles that we're using, and I'm going to give you a little bit closer view of these here. These are the traditional indoor rev handles right here. You can see that they're fairly straight. They have the slight bend in them as usual, and then the leaders on top here, and the series of knots that we would use for adjustment. For those of you that are just getting your first indoor rev, I would probably suggest that you start on the last knot right here. And then, of course, there's usually one knot down here. You'll typically want to hold the handles near the top of the foam, but as you spend more time and get comfortable with your kite, you'll find that you're going to develop your own style. But that's really a good place to start. When you're making the inputs, they're going to be fairly small, like this. And when you're flying, you also want to make sure that you keep your hands very much in front of you. You don't want to spread them out a great deal. The indoor rev, particularly, doesn't respond as well when you spread out by more than probably that far, unless you're doing a deep slide or something like I'll show you. But for general flying, again, keep your hands in front of you and not too far spread apart. Because what'll happen when you pull too far apart, the kite is going to end up turning sideways. And as we described, by angling the kite and directing it, if you turn the kite completely sideways, it has no pressure. So you can put all of the turn input you want, but if you've pulled too far, the kite is not going to respond to you. Now, having covered that and the indoor handles, I also wanted to show you these are the snagless, these are the outdoor handles that are available through Revolution. They've got a really nice finish on the top. And I'm gonna actually put two of these side by side, and you can see the difference here. So you can see there's quite a bit of difference in the angle of the handles, as well as the overall length. They basically produce different levels of response in your kite. I think that the indoor handles probably make the brake lines a little bit jumpier, a little bit touchier. And I look at them more in terms of like controlling a marionette or something like that. And the outdoor handles, I think the indoor rev responds a little bit more like an outdoor rev. But do not be fooled, it is a completely different animal. So the other thing that I'll go on to say as well is that in the various topics that we're going to cover in this series of tutorials, some things may feel like they're partially left unanswered in one tutorial and then another, but the trick with indoor rev flying is that the skills are so interrelated that if we actually covered every single aspect of a particular skill in one video, we'd end up talking in circles and end up covering 12 different items in one video anyway. So it proves to be a little bit challenging. So what I really recommend is that you browse the entire series of tutorials as they become available. And you know, for example, if you watch the whole series, go and implement and practice, and then you go back and watch that series again in a different order, you'll start to see how one aspect relates to another more, and you just feel sort of the gaps coming in as you apply it, review it, apply it, and then review it again. So, you know, practice is the name of the game. I think that's really our basic introduction to indoor revs, the basic controls. We'll get into a little bit more detail when we're actually flying. But, you know, other than that, I just ask that you enjoy the tutorials. I always welcome feedback, and of course, you can always find the entire collection on learnkites.com, and there's an additional reservoir of videos in the Kite Life subscriber section. So, as always, we thank you for your support, and I hope you learn lots from what we're showing you here.